zoning request, right, if there's a concern, if we pass this, if a business wants to be rezoned or a parcel, that has to come before us anyways. I mean, it would go to zoning. I don't mind continuing the conversation. I don't, there's things in here I don't like, but.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, Chairman.
Yes, Counselor.
Last meeting, we asked about what the ramifications would be if the petition drive goes forward, As of 2:45 today, which I haven't even read, that's not good timing on the part of our attorney. If you're representing the council, I would appreciate getting something of help of us from that, pardon my language.
To the chair.
I would expect an explanation.
To the chair, if I may, since the last meeting, I have had a household of company. My son and his family have been in from California, which has taken away a lot of time that I've been able to devote to. So I do apologize to Councilman Slavin. As I did indicate today, I intend to issue a lengthy and detailed opinion on the issue. It is complicated. I have spent the time researching it, but it's much more complicated than a simple answer. I gave you the short answer today so that you would know. My understanding was that the ordinance that was placed on the agenda today was to begin discussion. I don't think the ordinance is ready for a first reading. I don't want to make substantive changes between now and the second reading, as I think there needs to be a number of substantive changes. But again, I apologize to Councilman Slavin. I will make sure I get you a timely opinion before the next meeting. Counselor.
Were you done, Mr. Slavin?
Yes.
I have quite a few. Okay. And I'll try to, because I know this is short. Okay, so 712 and 713, what are the difference between these two? Just for, you know, people and myself, you know, I just want to. So one is the commercial business draft 330, and the other one is the zone. So those are two different models, right?
No, they're intertwined but affect different sections.
Okay.
Right? So if you look at section 9.1 versus amending the appendix into zoning by adding Article 11. So one is speaks to the other, and this the second has the definitions of what the zoning is. That's why I'm saying if you read the first one, it doesn't talk to distances, but in the zoning appendix 7.13, that's where it gets specific. So, and I don't have it right here, but if you pulled up the City of Taylor Charter as well as codified ordinances, you'd see where this kind of slots into the current numbering structure. So.
Okay. So, thank you.
Welcome.
So, so would there be, you know, if something gets, would there be two separate, or would they be combined as the one?
They are read harmoniously within, so they're not different.
Does it have to be that way, or is that just, is there a design, is there a reason?
This is exactly how Kalamazoo did it. So you have the actual ordinance, which then references zoning, but you have to add in the definitions in the zoning table.
Okay.
Right, so one is kind of, this is the substantive portion of the ordinance, but you also need to modify the zoning tables. What does it mean? What are the distances? Again, between now and the next meeting, I could go through exactly how, you know, Kalamazoo did that. I spoke directly with their corporation counsel, who I think may have retired by now. It's getting pretty close to getting retired. He is retired. But that's just kind of the form and structure. But the probably the key thing to look at it.
I read both of them.
Yeah.
So I have a few more questions.
All right, go ahead.
Okay, so do you agree then that there's a lot of changes that need to be made before we do the first reading? I mean,
that's a question that I don't. There were changes that I know that their attorney was looking at as well, but those had not been codified in Kalamazoo thus far. Yeah, go ahead.
I did speak to Clyde Robinson last Thursday or Friday, and he has just submitted a number of changes to their ordinance to the council. They've not been approved yet by the council, but he was going to share those with me. So as soon as they're approved by the council, public information, I can share those with this council.
Since this is such an important issue to the city, why is it that we can't have a committee of the entire council going here and wherever to a roundtable situation, and each of us have input into these ordinances? Why is it that one person has to write an ordinance and say, here it is?
Mm-hmm. The purpose of having a council meeting is to discuss things, and that's why we're here. There are no standing committees. If you would read our charter, there are no standing committees within the charter of the city of
Tampa. I'm not saying we need to have...
So there is not one person that is writing this. This is one person who has proposed it and is looking for the input of all seven council members. And I will take exception to Mr. Slavin in terms of how you just raised that question, because it wasn't a question. It was a condemnation.
No, it's not. What I'm saying is, I feel like all of us should have input when it's being written initially. Everything that I've ever been involved in, we have input from every aspect of the group. What I'm saying is when the group sits down and writes something and we all have input on an item-by-item basis, you get more complete ideas.
That is why we had a vote in April to put it on for discussion in May. That was shot down. I'm fine. If you show me your homework, I've showed you mine, but I haven't seen any homework from, quite frankly. So, because I've actually put pen to paper, I am somehow in that you're taking exception, that I've taken, put pen to paper and put down thought. If you have a better thought, please present it.
Not what I'm saying, Mr. Chairman. What I'm saying is, if we all had input at the time of writing, then we wouldn't have to sit down here and discuss that.
And if that were the case, we wouldn't have anything.
Are you done, Mr. Slavin? Okay. So this ordinance, are both of these, the first one was drafted by Greco, right? Or where did the first one come from, and the second one is Kalamazoo, or? They're both Kalamazoo. So you didn't write these ordinances. These are Kalamazoo's ordinances, sort of with some additions to them that were redlined to us before. Is that right?
What I've presented is I went through line by line to make certain that Kalamazoo's ordinance fit within our structure. It is pretty much verbatim on what has actually worked. It was, now, putting it into a format that is legal, right? How they label their sections and their numbering system is completely different than ours.
Okay.
So that's probably the major portion, is to make certain that it could be harmonious with how our chart works.
Okay. All right, so a couple of the things that I saw, I agree that I agree with what Mr. Plato said, but I do think that it's too early for a first reading. I think that there is a lot of changes in here, like the date, and I had some questions, and Ms. Winton had some good questions, and you had some good questions. Well, but one thing I saw was, or I was curious about, is like, if you don't do all the things that are in there, I saw the $500 fine, Is that too small? Because what you're asking them to do could cost more than $500, so they might as well just pay the fine and not do what they're supposed to do, you know what I mean? And who is regulating that, and how are we going to police that?